There are many ways to fit a line through a cloud of points. This video accompanies Open Interest Statistics' discussion of fitting a line by least squares regression, which is the most common approach to estimating a regression line. In particular, we will discover that least squares regression is an intuitive and objective measure for finding the best line. We will discuss necessary conditions for the least squares line to be appropriate and methods for finding the least squares line. Then we will get some practice interpreting the parameter estimates of the line. And in additional topics, we will see that extrapolation is dangerous and we'll practice using R-squared to describe the strength of a fit. We begin by thinking about what we mean by best. Mathematically, we want a line that has small residuals. Remember, residuals are the distances between the line and the data. The most common practice is to choose the line that minimizes the sum of the squared residuals. This is commonly called the least squares line. The least squares line is the most commonly used, and it is relatively easy to calculate by hand or with software. It is important to keep in mind the assumptions for linear regression. When fitting a least squares line, we focus on three requirements. First, the data should show a linear trend. If there is a nonlinear trend, an advanced regression method from another book or later course should be applied. Second, generally the residuals must be nearly normal. When this condition is found to be unreasonable, it is usually because of outliers or concerns about influential points. Third, the variability of points around the least squares line must remain roughly constant. The first panel shows an example of nonlinearity. We see a distinctive curvature in this case. The second panel shows an example of non-normal residuals. Notice the outlier towards the left. And the third panel provides an example of non-constant variability. You can see the points fan out towards the right. Lastly, we should also exercise caution whenever we notice structures in the data that are not accounted for by the least squares line. The Elmhurst dataset links gift aid and family income among 50 freshman students at Elmhurst College in 2011. We are interested in exploring the possibility of a linear relationship between these variables. We could write the equation of the least squares regression line as follows. Estimated aid equals intercept coefficient plus slope coefficient times family income. Here, the equation is set up to predict gift aid based on a student's family income, which would be useful to students considering Elmhurst. The values beta 0 and beta 1 are the coefficient parameters of the regression line. Parameter estimates are commonly found using statistical software. In this case, B0, the estimate of the intercept parameter, equals 24.31, and B1, the estimate of the slope parameter, equals negative 0.0431. What do these numbers really mean? Interpreting the slope parameter is helpful in almost any application. For each additional $1,000 of family income, we would expect a student to receive a net difference of $43.10 less aid. Note that a higher family income corresponds to less aid because the coefficient on family income is negative in the model. We also must be careful in this interpretation. While there is a real association, we cannot interpret a causal connection between the variables because these data are observational. The estimated intercept, B0 equals 24.3, describes the average aid if a student's family has no income. The meaning of the intercept is important since the family income for some students at Elmhurst is $0. In other applications, the intercept may have little or no practical value if there may not be observations where x is near zero. Linear models can be used to approximate the relationship between two variables. However, these models have real limitations. Linear regression is a modeling framework. The truth is almost always much more complex than our simple line. For example, we do not know how the data outside of our limited window will behave. Let's use the model estimated aid equals 24.3 minus 0.0431 times family income to estimate the aid of another freshman student whose family has income of $1 million. Recall that the units of family income are in thousands of dollars. So to calculate the aid for a family making $1 million, we would set the family income variable equal to 1,000 and be left with an estimated aid of negative 18.8. Incredibly, the model predicts that this student will have negative $18,800 in aid. However, this makes no sense because Elmhurst College cannot, or at least does not, require any students to pay extra on top of tuition to attend. The R-squared of a linear model describes the amount of variation in the response that is explained by the least squares line. The variance of the response variable, aid received, is 29.8. However, if we apply our least squares line, we can reduce our uncertainty in predicting aid by using information about the student's family income. The variability in the residuals describes how much variation remains after using the model, which in our case is 22.4. In short, there was a reduction of 25% in the data's variation by using information about family income for predicting aid under the linear model. This corresponds to an R-squared value of 0.25. In this video, we were introduced to topics relating to fitting a line by least squares regression, including regression using statistical software, interpreting coefficients, the dangers of extrapolation, and R-squared as a method for describing the strength of a fit. If you learned something you found interesting, share this video with a friend and visit openintro.org for more resources.